Okay. And the answer is Memcached just throws away data that is least recently used. So as you insert more and more keys in the Memcached, if there's not enough room, keys that you haven't accessed in the longest amount of time just get purged from the cache automatically. So the cache automatically has the most recently accessed things. Let's talk about some of these other answers. It doesn't throw an error. Now, if this was a database, it should throw an error because you want your database, you rely on your database to store your data. And if it's not going to be able to store it, it should tell you. It shouldn't just silently, accept new data and throw away old data or something like that. But Memcached, it's not an error to store too much data. It can only store so much. The next answer, throw away data that is least frequently used. This is commonly referred to as an LFU cache, least frequently used. This is a common way of doing caches, but Memcached doesn't do it that way. They use what's called an LRU cache, which, is least recently used. Least frequently used implies some sort of notion of keeping track of how many times each key is accessed. It's a little bit harder to implement than least recently used, which is just a simple sort, just throw the key to the front, add the key to the front of the list. And the final answer, write the extra data to disk. As we said, Memcached is entirely in memory. There are variations of Memcached that write extra data to disk, but writing to disk means, it's a performance trade-off. Writing to disk is slow. Reading from disk is slow. If you want to be writing data to disk, Memcached probably isn't the right solution for you. You can use a database or you can use some other piece of technology that's, kind of splits the difference, sacrifices a little speed for a little bit more durability or space or whatnot.